BBC Radio Manchester.
Good afternoon, it's Natalie Pike on BBC Radio Manchester. I'm in for Becky today and I'll be here with you until 6 p.m. with so many great songs. That was Dancing on the Ceiling by Lionel Richie. Now, I've got to say, it's producer Lawrence's first time working with me and I think he's currently looking through the glass on every song as I dance away in the studio enjoying the music. And I think he's thinking, who have we got presented here? Because, of course, you'll usually hear me on Talking Ball 6 till 7 p.m. Monday to Friday. with Gaz or our Emily as well, talking all things football. But today, I'm honoured to be with you before 6pm. I'm out in the daylight and I'm enjoying the drive show. I'm enjoying your afternoon show today, and it's a real, real pleasure to be here with you all. If you'd like to get in touch with me, if you'd like to say hi, let me know what you're doing on this bank holiday, and especially if you're in work, I'd love to hear from you. Shout out to everybody that's grafting today. It's 81333. Start your text with the word Mank, or you can give us a ring. It's 0800 218 2255. It's always, always lovely to hear from you. Now, we have some great songs coming up for you before 4pm. If I can't have you, I don't want nobody, baby. Yes, we've got Yvonne Elliman. We've got John Newman. And every dad's favourite band, it's ELO. It's a given thing. What a terrible thing to lose. And up next for you, another one this. So why?
To dance our way out of our constriction. Gonna be freaking up and down the hang up alleyway. With the groove I only got, we shall all be moved. Ready or not, here we come. Getting down on the one which we believe in.
Can I get it on my good foot? Good God. About time I got down on the end.
We're on the move, but they can't stop us now.
Hey, don't tell me now.
Giving you more of what you're talking for.
Pike, and I'll be here with you through until 6pm on this bank holiday Monday. Now, tomorrow your school might be striking. My son's school is. He is five, and his school has been on strike every one of the days where they could have been. And the last time, so not Thursday gone, the one before that, I had him and I had his friend for the day. And I took them off to the Science and Industry Museum, which I can highly recommend. I imagine it'll be quite busy tomorrow because it's it's also free. It's free to get in as well, which is just absolutely fantastic. There were so many things for them to do and touch and run around and play with. They loved it. We came out of the Science and Industry Museum, we walked up the road, we got a chippy, and then we walked round the corner, and I managed to blow their little five-year-old minds when I took them to the Castlefield Roman Gardens, because they did not expect in the centre of Manchester there to be a castle, is what they were calling it. You know, they're five, it looks like a castle to them. And they absolutely loved it. So if you're looking for something to do tomorrow, I could highly recommend that, because it's free. The Science Museum is free, and then you can walk around the Roman Gardens as well. So the Roman Gardens used to be home to a Roman fort with around 500 soldiers garrisoned there. Now, it is the place where the Romans first settled when they arrived in Manchester 2,000 years ago, and it could be getting a major revamp later this year. But campaigners say the gardens are now looking sad and unloved, and they're hoping to raise £3 million to improve the site. The chair of Castlefield Forum, Callum McGowan, has been speaking to our reporter, Jacqueline Payne.
Here we are in some really quite attractive gardens on a chilly spring morning. We're opposite the Museum of Science and Industry, and I'm just in the shadow of the Beetham Tower, actually, and these gardens have huge historical significance, don't they?
Yes, absolutely. We stood right at the birthplace of Manchester. This kind of settlement was brought together in AD 79 by the Romans, who set up shop here.
And so the reason why Manchester, or Mamukium, as it was called, was here was because it was on a very important strategic route between the east and west of the country.
This settlement here was set up to connect Chester and York. Down the bottom of the gardens, which is at the south end, you've got what is we call the North Gate. It's largely reconstruction, but at either end you can see some original bits of quite scrappy wall. Those are original bits of Roman wall going back to AD 79. And just in front of them, there are some kind of protective ditches, which were defences. So if we walk over there, we can have a look at those.
We're walking effectively in the footsteps of where some Roman soldiers would have come through thousands
yes,
of years
yeah,
ago.
We probably should march, actually, but it's a little bit cold and chilly for that. So there you go, there's the granary. So if people come and visit the gardens and head over this way towards the Castlefield Arena, or the Bowl as it's now called, you can see the granary. So all of that section there that had been grain stores.
To feed the soldiers
to feed the hungry. Exactly.
It was a good size fort, is my understanding.
It was huge, absolutely enormous, absolutely enormous. And you can follow little traces of it around the area, but sadly a lot of it was obliterated by the Industrial Revolution. So we haven't got the kind of amazing walls that you see in Chester and York. Sadly, we've just got these little scraps. So our duty is to just help look after them.
What is the plan that you've got for this area now?
It's perfectly okay at the minute, but we really see the potential to open up the site, to unlock an east-west route, a path across the gardens, make it much nicer and safer at night. You'll look around, there's no lighting at all. So we've got some funding through already to get this all relit. We want to completely replant everything. We've had tree surveys done. There's lots of good trees to keep. There's some scrappy ones to take out. Really just open it up and make it much more accessible. You can see the whole thing is fenced off. We want to tear down the fencing in the majority of places and make it much more open, more accessible, and just more pleasant to be in, whether it's daytime or nighttime.
I come here every day.
To walk the
dogs, yeah. Even though I'm from here and I walk here every day, I don't really know much about it. So, yeah, it would be good if there was some more signage, more information, like you say, open it up a little bit.
Well, I think there should be more excavations, and it should probably be better signage. Romans were living here for many centuries.
There's a huge visitor population that comes to Manchester every year, and we want to capitalise on that. We love people coming to enjoy our neighbourhood, and this opens the site up even more. There you go, even the crows enjoying it. This just celebrates what we have and really showcasing it. At the minute, can you really tell this is a Roman site? We want to just make it much more obvious that this is a wonderful place to come and explore, whether you like your history or you want to have your butty at lunchtime.
Jacqueline Payne reporting there, and I can fully concur with that, although we did a chippy at lunchtime. We took it from around the corner and we went and sat in the Roman gardens there. I loved that, absolutely love it. I can highly recommend it. If your kids are off tomorrow, take them to the Science and Industry Museum. It's free. And then take them for a walk around Castlefield's Roman gardens. Like I said, blew my five-year-old's mind that there was a Roman fort in the middle of Manchester. I'm Natalie Pike. It's BBC Radio Manchester, 19 minutes past three. Now, this man, Lewis Capaldi, isn't he wonderful? Well, he brings out big tune after big tune, doesn't he? Every single thing he touches is a hit. And his new song, well, it's certainly the same, isn't it? What a tune. Here's Wish You the Best on BBC Radio Manchester.
Bench out and jelly due to my splendor. Move, move, a smooth groover. Dudes from the zoo that play the mic like, wow. Walk where the cane, talk where the slang develop on crooked blocks which I walk. But my radius is the whole universe. Kiss yourself goodbye, cause I'm uno, you know, plus bus. She's dime, let me try her. Gold smile, throw in the power beneath my sun visor. She built with sun visor, it's that in the third. Love, love, every day, that's my word. When I see your crew, I say that's them her. Sublime, blind, blood clot, and it just don't stop. Fresh. Lush, black, slip, right off the block. Fire. No doubt, we turns it out, cause we keep black booming the cast. So keep rocking, plus hang with my niggas and hit the dope spots. Play in the corners and maybe even boogie, tell the sun come up, call the gun, come up. Shooting at the breeze, the local MCs. Styling with ease. Doing it like the sun is in here, cause we born rhyme saying, but I ain't playing. Blowing out, 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 blowing out.
Black on time, bed still laying like I said, under the screen with your eighth wonder. So for Dania, I do it. Shit, push a little fist, fit my 120s, greet the Avenue Blue. Corner flying it into a 40, 20 brothers lay in the bottle. 30 fly right by, double time and shit. X I'm hitting so I can step sooner. More than over, so nowhere to go south. So see my G, yeah, she coming in. We not a flesh vendor, mecca got soul, living soul, living soul. Shot open on my left just in time. No B finger pops it to a little one. It's cool.
In a sense, we smoother than all these contents. Loyal to the kick drum like flavor. Bounce, bounce, ease back. When we do it fluid.
Yes, make a tight fresh.
Blowing out, 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 blowing out. We always blow out.
Without a doubt, without a doubt.
What a funky side of town, no doubt.
Yes, yes, sure, yes, yes, sure.
We always blow out.
Check it out.
For the funky side of town, no doubt. Word. We get slaver than any 85 in the phone pots.
Check it out, out here, out and
every crew's battle, we choose to rock fatter. Cause I stimulate
life and matter. When I spread my wings, I do's my thing. Cause Doodle Big wants to live like a Zulu king. So I swing with my crew to where the beats be fat. Swoon units by the pound and they natural black. Without a doubt, this is the place to be. I see baseball caps, hear beats by Ron G. I sinks into the mold of the cool out breeze. You know the cool breeze, rocks the beat sweaty. So nigga please, full of the dreadful wedding. The sun, moon, set in the house ready to set it. With the peace signs, fat rhymes, the planet fix. Add butter to the Met, then jet to 86.
Blowing out, blowing out, blowing out, blowing out, blowing.
You better blow that shit out.
Natalie Pike.
BBC.
Radio Manchester.
Von Elliman on BBC Radio Manchester. It's Natalie Pike. It's 3:27. I'm here with you through until 6 p.m. And I just want to give a big shout out to 77-year-old Susan Rogers, because she went viral this weekend when a video of her was released on social media singing and dancing her little heart out on the Metrolink. I absolutely love it. There's a story about it in the MEN today in which she says her daughter said that she was on the tram and there were some kids with the speaker playing loud music. And apparently Susan just turned to them and said, "Would you put something cheerful on?" And that lovely bunch of kids did exactly that. They popped on Sweet Caroline for her, and our Susan had a right boogie on the Met.